Let's take a look at how Redux works through a simple dot app. We'll talk about using Redux with Flutter a little later. Let's create the dot app from the command line. Now, when you install Flutter, dot is also automatically installed. So we can make a dot app using the dot command line tool. After executing dot create counter.redux command from the command line, move to the counter.redux folder and execute the .pub/add/redux command to install the Redux package. I ran VS Code in the current folder. If you look at the left panel, you can see the bin folder and the lib folder. Let's open the counter.redux.dot file in the bin folder. There are an import statement and a main function, and the file imported by the import statement is the counter.redux.dot file under the lib folder. Now, since we don't need this import, the argument of main and the statement in the main function will delete everything, import the .redux package. First, we define the state we'll be dealing with in our Redux app. The state can be any value. That is, it can be a primitive type such as integer or string, or it can be a data structure such as a class. However, even when primitives can be used, I will create and manage the state as a class as much as possible. This is because when the number of states to be dealt with in the future increases, scalability is good and you can enjoy the benefits of dot type checking. Since we make a counter app, we create a class called counterState, declare a final variable of integer type called counter, and create a constructor. And I will create a variable of counterState type called initialCounter and give a counterState instance with a count argument of 0 as an initial value. Next, we define actions that affect the state. Action consists of the type of action to be done and payload, which is additional data required to perform the action. When using Redux in React, action is defined using the following JavaScript object. The type of action to increment counter is defined as counter/incremented. However, if string is used, there is a risk of typos and errors. In addition, if you use a string in Dart, you lose the benefit of type checking provided by Dart. So in Dart, when creating an action, instead of using a data type like map, enum or class is used. If you do not need additional data to perform an action, you can use an enum, but I will use a class as much as possible. If you use enum or class, you can use type checking provided by Dart. So the chance of an error is greatly reduced, and the additional data is much cleaner because you can pass it as an argument of the class. Let's create an increment action, an action that increments the counter by the payload. Create an increment action class, declare an integer type final variable payload, and create a constructor. Let's create a decrement action, which is an action that decrements the counter by the payload. Create the decrement action class, declare an integer type final variable payload, and create a constructor. And when creating the action class, I will name the class so that it ends with action. This way, you can tell for sure that a class is an action just by looking at its name. Next, we'll create a reducer. Reducer is a pure function that takes two arguments. The first argument is a current state, and the second argument is an action object describing what happened. The reducer creates a new state using the current state and action. Create counter reducer that receives counter state type state in dynamic type action as argument and return counter state. If the action is increment action, it returns a new counter state instance where the value of counter is the current state.counter plus action.payload. Since increment action is a class, we can do type checking using the is operator. If the action is a decrement action, a new counter state instance is returned where the counter value is the current state.counter minus action.payload. Just like increment action, we can do type checking using the is operator. If there is no corresponding action, the existing state is returned. In counter reducer, you use the is operator, much safer than using string. However, when counter reducer returns a new state, it returns a completely new counter state instance instead of mutating the existing state. This was not done intentionally, and Redux requires that all state updates be immutable. However, object immutability is very easy to implement in Dart, just as in counter state, declare member variables final. And by using the following copy the function, you can easily create a new instance that differs only in the value given as an argument of the copy the function. Currently, there is only one argument, but if there are multiple arguments, you only need to provide the argument you want to change. This is very convenient because you don't need to provide all arguments when generating a new state. Now, we'll modify the reducer to use the copy the function. We will modify the count state of increment action and decrement action to state the copy with the function. Now, since there is only one argument, the benefit of using the copy the function may not seem great. However, when the state becomes more complex, it is much more convenient to use copy with. And defining the toString method more descriptive is very helpful when debugging. We'll override the toString method as well. And if you create an initial state within the counterState class, it is more convenient because you can see what the initial state is just by looking at the countState class. We'll create a factory constructor called counterState.initial and return a countState instance with a counter value of 0. Since we create a factory constructor called counterState.initial, we'll delete the initial state variable. Where initial state is required, you can use the counterState.initial factory constructor. We will override the toString method for actions as well. Overriding the toString method is useful for debugging later. And once again, since reducers are pure functions, they should not execute side effects such as logging or HTTP calls. Next, create the store. The store acts as a repository that holds the app state tree. The only way to change a store's state tree is to dispatch an action. Dispatched actions are sent to the reducer to update the state tree. Next, create a store. When using the reducer in React, we use the createStore function, but in Flutter Redux, we create the store instance. To create a store instance, reducer and initial state must be provided, where initial state is a named argument. Another important argument is the middleware named argument, which we will look at later. Declare a counter state type final variable store and assign a count state type store instance. Give counter reducer as a reducer argument and counter state.initial factory constructor as the value of initial state argument. Store instance provide state getter. You can access the app state using this state getter. This is similar to the role played by the getState function in Redux.js. The store also provides a dispatch method. This dispatch method is used to dispatch an action. Dispatch the action is passed to the reducer. Store provides an onChange stream that emits state whenever the state changes. Listen for state changes using the listen function of the onChange stream of the store. The listen function takes a void type function which has a count state type state as an argument and returns a stream subscription of count state type. Let's print the current state from the function body, and we will store the return value of the listen function in a variable called subscription. The subscription variable is used to cancel a subscription to a stream later when it is no longer necessary to listen to the stream. Let's dispatch actions. Dispatch an action using the store's dispatch function. Let's dispatch increment twice in a row. I will give a first increment an action a payload of 2 and the second increment action with a payload of 3. After delaying for 1 second, we dispatch a decrement action. For this, we'll modify the main function to be an async function. We'll give a delay of 1 second using the future.delayed function. Next, we dispatch the decrement action using the dispatch function of the store. It will give 10 as the payload of the decrement action. Cancel the subscription when you no longer want to print the state to the console. Open a terminal and run it. Enter .run command in the command line. However, the result of the last dispatched action does not appear. This is because the onChange stream is an async stream. This is because the subscription is canceled after the decrement action is dispatched and before the state calculation is completed. There are two workarounds for this. The first is to use a sync stream. To do so, you need to set the store's sync stream option to true. Default value is false. Now let's run it. Everything is executed in order. By the way, I have never used the sync stream when making an actual app. If sync stream is set to true, processing of subsequent events is delayed until processing of one event is completed. The second way is to give the async stream a chance to compute the state before canceling the subscription. Before cancel, we give 0-second delay. Let's run it again. Yes, all states were output normally. As a side note, when using Redux in a Flutter app, you don't need to go through a procedure like subscribing to a store. The utilities provided by the Flutter Redux package do the job for you. The basic concept of using Redux in React is the same, but there are some formal differences. In React, the getState function is used to access the state in the store, but in Dart, it is accessed using the stateGetter of the store. Let's take a look at what has been said so far. This figure is from redux.js.org. Actions are dispatched in response to user interactions, such as button taps. The store executes the reducer function to compute the new state. The UI reads the new state generated by the reducer function to display the new value. You may not understand it well now, but think of it as understanding the structure of the Redux app, and you don't have to worry too much about the details. We will make several apps, so you will get used to it quickly.